Bola salati, bola salati, non mi ci può che con manco ne vuole salati, bola drums, you have the capacity to create a mood for any amount of people. Doesn't matter if you're playing in a club, if you're playing in a hall, if you're playing in the streets at a carnival, you create the scene that's happening.
Thank you. Brothers, I come before you tonight as the preacher, the son of a preacher, preacher immersed in the movement at 5 years old. I don't come tonight representing any organization, but I come to talk about faith and morality. I'm a preacher and I'm a theologically conservative liberal evangelical biblicist. I know it may sound strange, but I'm a conservative because I work to conserve a divine tradition that teaches us to do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with our God. I've had the privilege of traveling the country with the Reverend Dr. James Forbes and Reverend Dr. Tracy Blackman and Sister Simone Campbell, as we are working together in the revival and calling for a moral revolution of values. And as we travel the country and we see some things, that's why I'm so concerned about those that say so much about what God says so little, while saying so little about what God says so much. And so, in my heart, I'm troubled, and I'm worried by the way faith is cynically used by some to serve hate, fear, racism, and greed. We need to heed the voice of the scriptures. We need to listen to the ancient chorus in which deep calls unto deep. The prophet Isaiah cries out, "What I'm interested in seeing you doing," says the Lord, "as a nation is, pay people what they deserve. Share your food with the hungry. Do this, and then your nation shall be called a repairer of the breach." Jesus, a brown-skinned Palestinian Jew, called us to preach good news to the poor, the broken, and the bruised, and all those who are made to feel unaccepted. Our Constitution calls us to commit our government to establish justice, to promote the general welfare, to provide for the common defense, and to ensure domestic tranquility. Now, to be true, we have never lived this vision perfectly, but this ought to be the goal and the heart of our democracy. And when religion is used to camouflage meanness, we know that we have a heart problem in America. There have always been forces that wanted to harden, even stop the heart of our democracy. But there have also always been people who stood together to stir what Sister Dorothy Day called a revolution of the heart, and what Dr. King called a radical revolution of values. I say to you tonight, some issues are not left versus right or liberal versus conservative. They are right versus wrong. We need to embrace our deepest moral values and push for a revival of the heart of our democracy. When we hear legitimate discontent of Black Lives Matter, and we come together to renew justice in our criminal justice system, we are embracing our deepest moral values and reviving the heart of our democracy. When we love the justice for all. We can't give up on the heart of our democracy. Not now, not ever. In this house, is there a heart?
Skateboarding is not a hobby, and it's not a sport. Skateboarding is a way of learning how to redefine the world around you. It's a way of getting out of the house, connecting with other people, and looking at the world through different sets of eyes. When you're a skateboarder, especially in the 1970s, when everyone thought it was a hobby, and they all thought it was a strange version of a yo-yo or a hula hoop, it was very under the radar. For most people, when they saw a swimming pool, they thought, let's take a swim. But I thought, let's ride it. Let's see what the transition is like at the bottom. When they saw a street, they would think about driving on it. I would think about the texture. I slowly developed an ability, I think, to look at the world through totally different means. I had a whole other idea of what was happening. Weather played a very different role in my life at that time. If it rained, like today, would be a miserable day for me. So I became a skateboarder.
It is about what you feel, what you do, how you choose to present yourself when the situation requires you. It is about what you're looking for, what you search for. It is not about fulfillment, but it is about what is missing. How do you improve? How do you progress? Are you searching? It is about the mind, how it grows progressively. What do you feed it? How do you cultivate the mind? It is about the galaxies and the stars, but not so much about the moon as much as is it about you. It is about choices, much as it about decisions, but it is about having the bravery and the strength to make those things come to fruition. What is it you're searching for? It is about a pause, a break, an interruption in the transmission, a stop in the space-time continuum, a choice that you will always make, a moment in being when you realize that you are what you are searching for. So I will ask, what is it you are searching for? It is about infinite tomorrows, but it is also about yesterdays and how the past repeats itself. So how will you choose to repeat yourself in their lives? It is about now. It is about then. What is it you are searching for? What is it you are searching for? Is it the now? Is it the no? Is it the yes? Is it that subsequent I love you that you need? What is it you are searching for? What is it you are searching for?
story about a man that walks into this big dark room. And this room is full of light, full of smoke machines. And he feels like he's just in his old house. There was a child when he was like playing with his family on his little bike, feeling safe and forgetting all his troubles. Forgetting what he needs to do, who he has to pay, and not just not feeling inferior. Just not feeling inferior. In this room, worries and all the rules, what you can do and what you can't do, just vanish. The only thing that counts is respect. Respect your brother. Respect your brother. Respect your brother. This room is a magic room, but it's really not about the room itself. It's about the people in the room. It's about the moments you share, the smiles, the looks, the music, the DJ. It makes you feel like you're one thing. It makes you want to live forever. Instead of just thinking that it's you against the world. And you think, well, why can't we always live together like this? But it's really not about the room itself. It's about the people in the room. It's about the moments you share, the smiles, the looks, the music, the DJ. Feeling safe. Instead of just thinking that it's you against the world. It makes you feel like you're one thing. But why can't we always live together like this? It makes you want to live forever. The only thing that counts is respect. Respect your brother. It makes you want to live forever.
Baby, no. sounds so wonderful. Make me feel like I'm to blame. Being who I am. But I used to be. We can't deny ourselves. Never let the feelings go. It's true that I want this so much. Now it's time I should be letting you know. Cause when I'm around, I hear that sound of you tapping your foot. And as I stay here, this feeling, I feel that I could use so much. And fall in.